So, welcome to a new video. The last time I built this API interface for Python to generate some project names. This is a common problem I have. I don't know how to name my new project, and there's this the page name links, and here can enter some keyword, for example this, and then it will generate. Can create you some nice icons and some nice names. You can customize this name by the length for all this stuff. And the last time I built a Python wrapper, a Python API, so you can run this command line interface to generate some names. Because the problem I have is this already can. This page can already check if the domain is available, but not obviously not check if a name on PyPy, which is a name server for all the Python package, it doesn't check if the name is there available. So I have generate a name, and then I can then I have to copy them and check them by PyPy. And to make this simple, I have generate this tool that's automate check if its package are really available on PyPy and only then print them out. So this works fine. You can see how I do this, how I did this. But as I check the source of this tool, or as I work with this, I see these nice icons, really nice logos from this page, and as I check the source code from this page, I figure out that this is also an API call or a URL call which will generate these nice icons. I don't have checked this out, but this is what I want to do today. So let us start. So I open the debug console and let us check. So if you generate this, you see the load scroll back, you see the first call is the load to PHP file, which has all the names we have checked in the previous video, and you see there's a lot of information about the icon. I think I'm not sure if it's really, but we will find this out. So then there come a lot of calls from these information, which looks for me that this is the interesting part. So if I copy this URL and post it in a new window, I hopefully will not see the icon. No, God. But yeah, which would be here. But maybe there's some information where we can find the icon. Or I'm wrong and I can't generate a icon with this technique. So maybe we should check. So you see, it's nothing really special. I only check the source and try to figure out where this image came from. So I want to have an URL. What happened if I... So we have a little information. Maybe we have to check this page. Obviously a lot of JavaScript. So the same. Yeah, it's drawn by, so I think I should always, so SF. Yeah, so I think this is a, this item is an icon, hopefully. I'm not a web developer, so. Ooh. So maybe I said something stupid, don't blame me. Brilliant. And this, yeah. Font style, title. Okay, and then I think these are the values which draw this. So not that simple what I thought. But I won't give up for now. So then I will check the logo ripple logo. Logo. Place the logo. I know. And this will probably, let me copy this and go through my editor so I can simply see more. So if I save this in a can I open this with? It's open in the window. I will get these. So I will compare these quickly with the. Yeah, which could be. The background is not right, but the. Otherwise, it looks like. It could be something interesting. That means I don't have a simple icon that I can download. I only have this SVG formatted HMP file. So I have to convert them maybe. I'm not sure how to do this, but probably we will find it out. And obviously there will be a way to do this. Back, I need this. I will check if the result from, so so I will check if result from one of these, sorry, from one of these calls. So this is a special one, and this will return. What are these? I think this has a special path, and this is which will be drawn, and the SVH. SVH will be the hopefully interesting part. So, okay. Yeah, I have this open here. And I think this will be the... Okay, so I can get this from this XML style string. I can get this from the call if I enter all this. And maybe there's a Python package, I will check this out, who can generate from this SVG HTM file, which I can convert to a normal image file, like a JPEG or something like this. So, there are some tools, and they get them from the string. So this look interesting. Simply copy and paste from Stack Overflow. That's all the time. My daily work. So. Image, what is this and this? I have to check. Well, maybe I check the route to. Yeah, all the same stuff. Reading some documentation. Okay. So, obviously there's some working, has some working package I can use. So I don't have to do this by my own. This is a good. This is very good. So yeah, try this running. I'm not sure if it's which package. But we will find it out. Oopsie. Maybe this is include enough a package. Yeah. Simple into this package and then we will play. Alright. Inside the root environment. So we want to have this data, so we copy this inside the file. Yeah, I know this line is too long, but never mind. Sorry. And then we won't simply run this. I think it will break because of the miss this package. Maybe it's inside the package we installed for the conversion, but I think this will miss. But try it. So you see, I almost copy the error message. Separate search and mouse one of the first link will. So it should be a. Okay. There should be a package with his name, but there isn't. Okay, when I try to run the binaries from my operating system, let's run an Ubuntu. I'm not. Of its version, I think the newest, so which is which is already installed. Hopefully this is something old because it's missing Python 3, but hopefully we can fix it by this. So everything is right, then maybe it won't find this package because I'm running inside the virtual environment. This could be a problem. If I can try to import now these, will this break? And if I try this in a virtual environment, this will fail. So how can I install this inside a virtual environment? I think I. Okay, this is something like drawing. Let's sound like an image. So we will install this inside the virtual environment. Now this is one big problem of Python. You have no. Oh, I think I have to install wheel. But this is one big problem, for my opinion, for the PyPy package image, which it's not exactly the same name like you import inside a package. You can have a package with a name, with one name, and inside this package you have multiple models you can import. Like so, like you see, this is install py as a py kayo and not the only kayo. So I think. Fail to build if you install. If you install wheel. Okay. Then they maybe have a problem. Why is this so complicated? So hopefully this didn't work now. So we have to find this out. Maybe there's some information about. Inside the documentation office. Getting started. So we say we need this package, so we will simply install them. Maybe I missed some of this. And yes, I missed something. And now, hopefully, we can install this package. Yeah, this looks nice. And now we can run this script. And it didn't find this, why not? I didn't install this, I think. Okay. Back to read the document. Watch. Oh, this was the wrong one. I think this was. No, I didn't find this. Okay. Again, I was simple. Copy this. Yeah, maybe if someone has the same problem. It doesn't help me if I install this because I won't install this inside a virtual environment. So I will check out the PyPI page. Okay, there's nothing like. So where is this package? Well, I can't find this. Maybe I have to read more and not only click on links. So back to the first. Oh, I think it was here. Maybe we have changed this. This could be, this is something from this package. And as I check this documentation, maybe I will find there some information. So if it's something old and we have changed, we nothing I can find. So I think we probably changed where some naming of this. What is this crazy stuff? What is this? I never, also, obviously, I see something like this, but not quite often. Let us try this out. Why? No, it should be on the top. It's obviously there will be not this module because I don't install this. I don't like if it's get this kind of complicated. What's this? Focus, focus on the problem. So, what is this stuff and why it's gone? Close all these and now start again. All these things I don't need now. Back to this point. Nice and error. So I won't run it with Pi. Yeah, obviously this is my problem. What? Why it's so complicated to install this? Maybe I should use some other package? So this works. No, I will. This is not my problem. I can run this on Ubuntu. So, this sounds interesting. I want to check this out. Why not? Can someone explain me why I didn't check this out? Going back, well, so maybe we change the name. This look, by instead of this little. What's going on? Why it doesn't work? So I check out this documentation. I will check out the documentation from this package. The problem, I don't have a. draw to file. So it's going to be interesting that this loads properly from a file and not from a string. I have a string, but I check the source of this, and I probably will found of this documentation. I will found another function which will. Are there some documentation? Demos? This is already this function I want to have is from a string. Interesting. I'm not sure what's doing there. I think we both these. Embedded. Interesting, but this is interesting. No. I will check the function. So where come this from? Let's come from. So leap. Oh, I forgot the name. So maybe it's understand. No, it's a path. So we said it's a path, and it's good to and now this should be something where we can. Oh, obviously, I can convert this into a file, and then I can load this, but I won't do this. I will simply pass in the string and then format this and then convert this string. I don't want to write this to the storage. So there must be a function. Again, convert in. Where we get the root. So I think this is a simple something like an XML file, and this is a root of this. And there it's render the to the drawing. Okay, so where come this from? Okay, down there, some XML parser. Okay, nothing more than this, so the path. And then get the root, so I think I can I'm not sure. It's a little bit complicated than I thought, but XML parser from. I quite avoid XML, I don't know why, but I don't like this stuff. So this for a simple get reload. Why is this so complicated? Okay. This can be working, I try. Maybe on the top. And it says the root will be this. Okay. So we get the root and this is our string. Which will get us here. So now back to this library. We need this root. We need this pass in. Why the path? Gosh, I hope I get this, but no. Why I need the path? Main meat. Nice. Alright, I won't. This hurt my feelings. Why I need this path? But I won't do this from. Why can we not simply? I asked Google. So how was the name of his? Why is not the dark mode? String. Ah, okay, this is some error message. We see this. Oh, smash. So I think I do the ugly version. I will save my result in a file and then make these simple steps. And then I'm done. And next time. Oh, mouse. Next time, hopefully, we will get something nice. So this other function we really need. Test bug. hopefully. Is this right? And open this, convert this. And oh. Why? Oh. Because it's file PNG. And yes, oh, it's working. Yes, hopefully. Okay. This was much more point than I think. And it's an ugly solution. I really don't like this. But it's working. And it's okay. The problem will be with your don't forget, the thing we want to do is get these from some of these URLs. It's not complicated to get the URL, so instead of these stuff we want URL, so like this. Hopefully this is more secure. So then we can download this URL. You might write quickly a function, use the request module, and this should work. So like we have to on the last, in our last video, where I, so get file, and there you can specify the URL and the file name that we want to save this. Request point. Is this a get or is this a? This is a get request. Simple get request with all these parameters inside the URL. So simple get URL. Oh, sorry. And then data will be JSON. Now only simple print this, we don't need to return this, only for now, so I can see what data we already get. Come on this out. Ah, we don't call this function, this is stupid. So we have the URL, and we will call this with test. If I really build a package with this, I will take a temporary file. There's a yeah, and we get this. And elements. The one and the other one was this, so we have. Oh. What is. Was it this? Yes, we got this, and then they can write this inside the file. And this should be the file name. And if I delete this stuff. So now let's create this file. Now I can delete this, run this program, and we have this file. And this file can be converted with these functions to a PNG file. So And then we have our appearance. This didn't look nice. It really doesn't look nice. It really don't look nice. So, sorry. I think, yeah, we get some result, but not as I accept. Maybe I will load this up without adding it, because there was nothing special. Sorry for this. But maybe it's interesting to see how I try to figure out where's the problem, how can I get in result, and maybe the formation of this. But we knew, no, we get this result. It must be something interesting. I'm not sure. I don't know how this should work, and yeah, I will check this out. Maybe I'll do it without recording this, because I think that will be not a good result. But if you're already watching this 14 minutes video, thanks for watching. Hope we will see you next time with something more productive and something where you have a nice result. But don't forget, like and subscribe. It's really support me. Have a nice day. We will see you.